In today's video, I will be replacing the original Suzuki DF 2.5 horsepower carburetor jets with one size larger jets. My goal is to get a good carburetor setup. This will prevent the small jets from clogging up with bits of ethanol residue in the gasoline.
This is out jet. Now I will unpack it new bigger jet for carburetor for Suzuki DF. This is new pilot jet. This is the number. This is bigger one jet. And this is sticker.
I will reduce carburetor plugging and achieve stable low RPM on the Suzuki outboard. Also, the engine will slightly increase its power due to the large amount of fuel it will consume. In general, my idea for changing outboards is to achieve optimum performance of the outboard. In the video, I will break open the metal cap of the hidden mixture jet and adjust it. I will adjust the revs with the engine running. To unscrew the original size number 64 main jet. I use a screwdriver with the tip filed off. It is very important that the screwdriver fits exactly into the cut of the jig.
This is my special screwdriver.
Before screwing in the main jet, I drip a little oil to make it easier to screw into the thread. The new main jet is size number 66. The nozzle remains the original one.
This is my special second screwdriver. Now I will drill this metal cap. I mark in advance the place that I will drill. I use drill bit 3 mm. I will use an awl to remove the metal hook. Now I'm going to clean up the metal shavings. Here you can look mixture screw. This bolt is used to adjust the fuel air mixture.
I will use this little screw and turn on the vent.
This is what the mixture screw look like.
You did? One off.
Now I going to disassemble the top of the carburetor.
In its upper part, the carburetor is held by four screws, but in order to open its cover, I have to remove both axles on which the throttle valve and the suction are attached. It's the pilot jet's turn. It is located under that carburetor bolt. The original size is number 32.
This is too small. This is new jet.
I will put on one size larger, number 34.
I will change these O-rings.
Now I'm going to put new O-rings on the carburetor.
Good one. This is the new O-ring. I will put here. This is the second.
Now stay to the end of the video to see how I do a carburetor adjustment. Don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel.
Look at this spring. This is very important, the place of the spring. But first need to put this. everything, it's okay. Now I need to put this.
Now I check how to work carburetor. Everything it's okay.
This is the choke.
In the place of the metal cup, I will put silicone after the adjustment.
It's okay? Okay, give me one powerful like. Thanks for watching.